She started a blaze from one tiny spark I didn't even detect.
Hey everybody, Adam Weinberg here with another episode of Learn Something. Today we're going to tackle the tune Pebbles and Marbles by the band Phish. We're going to focus on the acoustic version that you might catch Trey play at one of the acoustic shows. And I learned this tune from watching him play it on the acoustic on the Craig Kilborn show back in 2011. So before we jump into it, this is a little bit more of an advanced lesson because not only is there a whole bunch of chord stuff happening, there's also a pretty cool fingerstyle pattern going. But I'm going to break it down as much as possible, and I think you can pick up pieces of it, and it's a cool thing, and there's a lot of different skills to learn throughout the tune. First thing to note, the tuning of the guitar is not your standard tuning. The version I learned it on, Trey actually detunes the whole guitar a half step, so his E is an E flat, etc. And then he tunes up the D string a whole step. What we're going to do, just for the sake of making this simple for everyone sitting there with their guitar, is we're just going to tune up the D string. So go to your D, and you're going to make it an E. You're going to tune it up a whole step. So I like to use harmonics, best way my ears hear it, till we got our E there. All right. So your tuning now is E, A, E, G, B, E. All right, so that's it. Kind of a funky thing you may not expect. It took someone else to hit me to that. I didn't think of it myself. I just thought Trey had insanely long fingers and was getting these voicings I couldn't get on my own. But that's what he does. Pretty cool trick. All right, so let's jump into the intro. I will, as a note, I'm going to call out kind of what happens because of this change in tuning, so that you can kind of understand the chords and you're not just memorizing shapes. You actually realize why they are what they are now. So let's start here. You're going to bar the ninth fret starting at the A string, and you're going to have your ring finger on the 11th fret and your pinky finger on the 11th fret, G and B string, and the bar. So this is actually an F sharp major. You know, you may think, well, that's F sharp major, and you'd be right, except that our D string has been tuned up a whole step. So what normally would be there as part of your bar and your ring finger when you look at that shape is now here, right? It's a whole step back because the string has been tuned up a whole step. So now you just have this, okay? So it's your F sharp major. Then just lift up your ring and pinky finger. So you just simply have that bar on the ninth fret. Okay, and now that is a C sharp minor, leaving the F sharp in the bass, okay? And then you slide in to a B major. So let's play those three chords again. F sharp major, C sharp minor with F sharp in the bass, B major. All right, so let's talk about that B major for a second. The B major is 9th fret on the, so you're keeping that F sharp, okay, in the bass, which is the 9th fret. We're now using our ring finger. We're going to play on the G string, which is our 3 of the B major, right? The third scale tone, which is your 8th fret on the G string. And then your 5 of the scale tone, which is your 7th fret on the B string. We play the 9 with the pinky down to the 1. So 9th fret with the pinky, pointer finger on B, which is the 7th fret. So again, 9, 1, 2, 1, right? Probably better say it that way, 2, 1. So again, those three chords, F sharp major, C sharp minor with F sharp in the bass, B major. Now we're going to keep moving. Talk about those three chords. So this looks like a difficult voicing, and you know, on an acoustic guitar it definitely takes a little bit of effort, But all it really is here is it looks like kind of your 1-3-5-1 voicing. Okay, but I'm barring it starting here on the 6th fret in order to get the 3 of the scale tone here, which Trey is plucking. Now what happens, because this D string is up a whole step, this is no longer your 3. Normally you're voicing here, and this is just an F sharp major shape, right? This would normally just be your F sharp major, but this is no longer your 3 of the scale tone. Normally this would be 1-3-5-1-3, but because the D is tuned up a whole step to an E, this is now your flat 5. So this is a major, this is a F sharp major with a flat 5. So, and this is how you pluck it. You're going to pluck the 1 and then pluck the flat 5. So you're plucking the A string, then you're plucking the D string. So again, the voicing, you've got your pinky on the 1, which is F sharp, and that's your 9th fret on the A string. You've got your ring finger, which is now in your flat 5, okay, which is the 8th fret on the D string. Your bar is covering the G string on the 6th fret. You have your middle finger here on the 7th fret on the B string, and your bar is covering the 3rd of the scale tone up here, which is your 6th fret on the high E string. And we just go pluck down a whole step. So we're going down a whole step to E major flat 5. And now we're going to just take this B major shape, right? Normally you look at a B major like this, but here we're doing it like this. Right, again, we play like this. Why? Because the D is tuned up a whole step, so we no longer need our finger here to play the 5 of the scale tone. It's now back here. So, okay. So all that's a big chunk of section, so let's look at it. I'm going to call them out. F sharp major, C sharp minor with F sharp in the bass, B major, play the 2, play the 1, F sharp major, flat 5, pluck the 1, then the 5, E major, flat 5, pluck the 1, then the 5, then B major. Now you have this little cool run. And that's going to end our intro. So let's talk about those chords. You have so voicing wise, really simple. But let's see what they actually are. So this here, okay, this is just your F sharp minor, right? Just again, you would think of it like this, but once again, because we're tuned up, we're here. We're just barring. So in your 2nd fret, and you're just barring from the D string down, just a bar in the 2nd fret. So slide up, you're going to do it on the 7th, bass note on the 5th fret, and barring the 7th fret. Okay, I like to use my pinky for the bars for whatever reason. Some people like their ring finger. Same thing here. This is really, I'm going to call this a B minor, actually, even though we have this. This is like the minor 3rd. And then you have the top of the B minor here, which is that bar on the 7th fret. So go down a whole step, A minor. Go down a half step, G sharp minor. Okay, and then bum, 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 which is A minor. I know I'm like a broken record here, so I'll say it one more time, and then from there I'll ignore it. But this is what you would think your A minor would be, but because we're tuned up on the D string, it's only these 2 fingers, right? First finger on the 1st fret B string, and middle finger on the 2nd fret G string. So, top half of a G with that open E string now. So that's just ring finger on the 3rd fret, low E string, middle finger on the 2nd fret A string, everything else open. Then we're doing that same voicing again that we just did for all the other ones. which is just simply a G sharp minor. Okay, and then we end with our main picking pattern. So let's talk about this. This pattern now is one of the classic Travis picking patterns. And it's what Trey's going to use now basically throughout the whole song. So you really got to practice it. Now, it's not the most natural pattern for me to play either. My right hand, I'm not great at these sort of more bluegrass flat picking style stuff. I was trained playing little classical things. So I kind of want to do like that kind of thing. That's not really what Trey does. So let's look at it. Actually, before we jump in, let me just play through the whole intro so you get it. I'll call it the chords, so you get a little knowledge while we do it. So here's the whole intro, start to finish. F sharp major, C sharp minor, B major, F sharp major flat 5, E major flat 5, B major. Then F sharp minor to B minor to A minor to G sharp minor to A minor to E minor. All right, this is actually an E minor. It looks like a G, but you're playing E minor. Okay, because that's your E. E minor, G sharp minor, and then C major flat 5, which is your main thing. Okay, so I'm going to show you my right hand here. The trick is that the thumb is always playing on the 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and... Now you'll notice that I got my arm kind of doing this up and down thing here, because naturally what my hand wants to do is this. That's not what Trey is doing. I don't know why that's what my hand wants to do, it just does. So I'm actually like counting out of my head and letting my arm kind of hit it. So if that helps, I would kind of recommend that. So you can see it on this camera. Let me go. One, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and what the other fingers are doing there. So you start with, I kind of pluck a bunch on that first one. So I am plucking the thumb, I'm plucking the A string, G, B, and E strings. And then the thumb has to alternate, and this is the real trick. The thumb has to continually alternate in the first chord, from the A string to the D string. So it's 1 and D string, 2 and D string. So 1 and 3 are on the A string, 2 and 4 are on the D string. And then you're alternating with your ring and middle finger on the E and B strings here. So give that a bit of a practice. I like actually just kind of moving my elbow just a little bit, the arm, to get that 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2. All right, so I'm not going to spend much time on that. I just kind of want to get you into all the chords. But that's something you just got to practice. All right, so here we go. All right, so let's jump in now to this main lick that's going to happen, which... you all know, it's kind of the famous lick of the tune. It goes like this. All right, so let's just talk about the notes. You're playing an open E, hammer on to the B string third fret with the ring finger. So that's open E, low E, hammer on to the third fret B string, high E open, pluck your B string and pull off. And now you're going to go. All sorry. So you're bending up on the third fret of the high E string, bend it down, open, pull off from the third fret on the B string. Okay? Now you're gonna slide up to this, which just kind of looks like almost like a full 1-3-5 G shape, but just play these with the open E string. You're gonna pluck that, these two, third fret, fourth fret, B and G string, back to an A. Again, your thumb's gonna be alternating. Right? You get that picking down, that finger style down. And this is just an A major. It looks like an A sus chord because I'm only playing these two. But again, because that D string is tuned up to an E, it's just your basic A. Okay, because the E is just the fifth of the scale tone now. So you have that. And then you do it again. Sorry. Now you slide up to that G. And now you're going to slide up to an A. Alright, so that's that. Now, instead of plucking that open E before your lick, you're going to pluck an open A. And again. Oops, sorry. Alright, so let's look at that real quick. So you pluck your open A, and you do the same lick. Now, by the way, when you're picking it, when you switch to the open A, instead of alternating from your E string to your D string, you're now alternating from your A string to your D string with your thumb. So it's, see that? So. And you go back to your A sus looking shape, which is just an A major. Now you slide up. Now here you're gonna slide up to what looks like kind of like you're playing an E major, but again, it looks like a 3-5-1 E major shape, starting on the fourth fret G string, fifth fret B string. But again, because that's an op, that's already tuned up to an E, you don't need that finger there. Okay, so you're just playing E. So you're sliding up E, A, then, which is hammer on to the first fret of the G string, and then just play your open B and open E. Okay, so let's take that again real quick, and I'll do it slow without really too much picking, so. Got it? Now comes another cool part. We're gonna play this lick now, but we're just gonna reharmonize the bass. So it's the same lick. It's that lick, but we're gonna reharmonize the bass. So the first new bass note we're gonna take is B. So put your pointer finger on B, and you're gonna do. Talk about these voicings because they're definitely a little tricky. So I like it, pointer finger on the note B, which is your second fret A string. You're gonna do the same lick, right? Hammer on third fret, open E string, pull off, bend up, right? But now to get this G shape, if we're gonna keep our thumb, we're gonna keep our pointer finger on B. So now I'm gonna play it with my ring and my pinky finger. So it was this, is now being played like this. Right, so it's. Sorry. okay? And now in order to get that A sus shape, that A major shape, I gotta switch my voicing. So I'm now putting my middle finger on the note B. So we do it with B, so. Now we're gonna go to G in the bass. I'm again gonna use my pointer finger. Now I've seen a couple people play it with their thumb. If you like that, go for it. It's not so comfortable for me, so I'm gonna put my pointer finger. I'm gonna use the same trick I just did on the B, so it's G. Actually, you know what? Play it with your middle finger, I think it's easier. So play G in the bass, which is just your third fret, right? Low E string. You're hammering on to get that note on your third fret B string. Pull off, bend it up, pull it off. There's your shape. There's your A, keeping your G in the bass. Now I'll go down to F sharp, pointer finger. Again, if it's easier with your thumb, you can do it like that. Nope, I'm not good at that. I like it like this. Pointer finger on F sharp, second fret, low E string. Notice how I switch my voicing again to get my middle finger on F sharp and keep that A there. And now you slide up and you're back to your A. All right, so let's talk about those bass notes real quick. We'll review them one more time. So B. Oops. B. G. F sharp. That same tag. So, which we already learned. Now we go, you pluck that, your voicing here, which is just your first fret, okay, on the G string. And you're gonna go, so let's look at what that is. That's all open strings except first fret on the G string. Sliding up to our E major. This is E major, right? Fourth fret, fifth fret. Okay, and now we've just got our ring and pinky fingers on the seventh fret of the G and B string. And we're plucking, what we're plucking here is just our open, which is an E string, but what normally is a D string. Plucking that's open. And we slide back down. All right, one more time. Next time. So that's the first pass. Second pass is. All right, now here we're going to come up to our E. This is just another E. And then. So this is F sharp, E, and back to your open voice. So let's review that. So you come out of your F sharp. E, A. Now Trey actually noticed on the video I saw, he's just going and goes back into plucking, but you could finger pick your way all the way through it. So you could go right, you could do it that way. You can mess with it and make it your own. Once we get to that, we're going to go on the last pass, we go which is an E7, right? E dominant 7, starting on your 7th fret, right? Barring it, A7 shape. All right, so let's get to there. Practice your E7 with the picking if you can. A7. Okay, so here now you're gonna land on your, this is like an A minor, right? So this is A minor, it's not like an A minor, it is A minor. And this is your 5-1-3 voicing. So you're going, move the first finger back a half step. So again, just to give you the frets here, you're gonna be on the 9th fret with your middle finger on the G string. I like to put my, I mean, there's so many ways to play it, but I put my pinky for whatever reason on the 10th fret on the B string and my first finger on the 8th fret on the high E string. I think I play it this way because I also think about the other voicing, which is right here. So I kind of like to see them stacked on top of each other. But anyways, you're gonna pluck that, your D string, which is really an E now. So move the one back a half step. Then you just have another voicing for an A minor right here, right? Which is barring the top three strings of the 5th fret. And that's the one you're putting back to the two, okay? Then we get to that funky major flat 5 shape again. So we'll review that real quick. You're coming out and you go into your E7 shape, A7 shape, A minor, A minor, A minor, A minor, right? Just all cool voicings of A minor. A minor, A minor, A minor, A minor. I mean, throwing in the two, so A minor 9s. And here's your E major flat 5 again, right? We had it way back in the intro, and it's this crazy looking shape. You see my, this has always been my problem here. This pinky finger since I was a kid, I got some kind of weird joint problem. The joint collapses, so I always got to be careful it doesn't mute the string accidentally. All right, so now we're going to land after that cool little pass onto the major flat 5 voicing that we had earlier on, which is going to sound like. All right, so just to review that real quick, that's your pinky here starting on the 1. In this case, it's E major flat 5. So the pinky's on the 1, which is the 7th fret on the A string. Your ring finger is on the D string on the 6th fret. Your bar is covering the 4th fret for your high E and your G string. And on the B string, you've got your middle finger on the 5th fret. And even though it looks like a major voicing, remember this is your flat 5 now and no longer your 3. So you start there with E in the bass. That's E in the bass on the 7th fret. Move the E to the low E string. So now it's on the 7th fret on the low E string, just your pinky. Everything else stays in place. That's the 5 of the scale tone. Now you're going to leave the B in the bass here, leave your bar in place, and your middle finger is going to come up and play the 5th fret on the D string, which is the. It's going to give it like a 4th sound, like a sus sound. And then you're just going to do a straight up bar, just a straight up minor 7th chord, okay? Which is now G sharp minor 7. So you have all these sort of variations of E major flat 5. So with E in the bass, with B in the bass, with the 4th, keeping the 5 in the bass. And then a G sharp minor 7 voicing, just barring the 4th fret, literally top to bottom. And then he does this cool little bah. So he's gonna, on the B string, You're going to hammer on to the 7th fret from the 4th to the 7th fret. So let's play that pass again. This is a really tricky pass in the tune. You'll see whenever Trey plays it, he, you know, slows down a second here as well. But it goes like this. B in the bass. The 4th. G sharp minor. All right. So that's that pass. Takes a lot of practice, that one, but you'll get it. I'm still practicing it. And then you go back to that A sus looking shape, which is really just A major. And then do a nice little pluck, hammer down on the 2nd fret high E string, put that F sharp in there, which is just, you know, adding a nice little scale tone to it, extending the chord. Okay, so this is now, this is just an E major, you know, if you've ever played E major like this, just a 5-1-3 voicing, but we're playing it as a bar here on the 4th fret from the G, B, and E string. We're going to bar it, and our middle finger on the 5th fret, so that we can land and add that other 5 of the scale tone, another B. Okay, so go to B minor, again just barring it, B minor, 7th fret, G, B, and E string, F sharp minor, 5-1-3 voicing, okay, and then as we did before, walk it down a half step, your first finger is going to walk it down from the 5th fret, okay, to the 4th fret, another F sharp minor voicing here, right, this is F sharp minor, just barring those three, on the 2nd fret, G, B, and E string, right, add your 5 again, no, sorry, you're adding your 3, your A, where am I, so, and then these beautiful chords to end it. All right, so let's talk about those last few chords. So we're here, kind of looks like a major 7th voicing. But because of this, like normally if this was a major chord, you would call this 1-3-5 major 7. But again, because of this weird tuning where this D is now an E, this isn't going to be a 1. I'm thinking about this more of like a C sharp minor, right? Like as if it was this, like if I was playing C sharp minor right here. So I'm thinking about as the top half of C sharp minor with a B. With a B in the bass, right, which is the 7th. So I'm thinking about this as like a C sharp minor 7th, I guess. Let's see if that sounds right. C sharp minor 7. Yeah, C sharp minor 7 is what let's call this. So we have C sharp minor 7 with B in the bass, then C sharp minor. Now we're going to walk it down with B flat in the bass, right? So I'm just walking down what I have on the D, now E string, right? So 7th fret, 6th fret, you gotta switch up your voicing here, right, in order to get the bass note there, and then your G sharp minor, and into your very beginning, your Travis pick. Hit that intro, do the lick one time, and then go up to this E, and I'm just playing an octave, This is what Trey played on that video I watched. So he's got a bunch of E's. It's just E, 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 and E, because you got the E string now. So E, E, and E. Playing the octave on the 7th to the 9th fret. And now come the lyrics. He started a blaze with G major, bar chord, one tiny spark, C major, and then an even detect lick. Back to your E here. She loved the light, was this? She loved the light, was this D major? Made by the dark star she seemed to respect. So, first pass is E major, right? Started a blaze with G major on the 10th to 12th fret, kind of your bar chord. C major, bar chord. I didn't even detect lick. Back to E major, octave chord. She loved the light, was this D major? Made by the dark. G major, the star she seemed to respect. A major. And this is your 5-1-3 voicing all the way up here on the 9th fret. And now the cool thing when you have that open E is you just pummel that E and get this great sort of harmony that happens throughout. So you're going to go. I'm just going to call it the chords. A major. Let's go up to this, right? G major. D major. And repeats. A major. E minor. G major. D major. And now when it goes to the pebbles and marbles, like words were right. Goes to this A major, right? We're just finding new voicings. Okay, so that's, again, you probably know it like this. We're going to keep this E open E string pummeling away, kind of your pedal. So that's 6th fret with your middle finger on the G string, and then you're barring your 5th fret on the B and G, high E string. So minor, G major, D major, repeat, G major, D major, back to your C major flat 5, lick, E octave chord, we'll call this. Then the second verse. C major, lick. Then to D major. To G major. A major.
Pebbles and marbles like E minor, words from a friend.
G major, seems to get lost, but are lost in the end. D major,
when I am alone, I something something. If I find a pebble in dust, D major, to think someone left it for us.
Okay, so on the second, wow, this is a long video. I hope you're all still with me. On the second, I'd love to know, if you guys could comment, I'd love to know how many people actually make it all the way through this. So on the second time through for the second verse, instead of just going down from that D major and then switching to A, you're going to go from D major back up to G major and then go to the A. So it's like this. I'll call it out. A major.
Marbles like E minor words from a friend. G major seems to get lost. D major, lost in the end.
A major,
I'm alone. With E minor, I'll seem to tend to G major. If I find a pebble in sand.
D major, back to G major.
A major, pebbles and marbles like what's on my mind.
G major, D major, A major, E minor, G major. D major. I'll do that again. A major.
minor, G major, D major. Right?
Now here there's actually a difference between the acoustic version and the full band version, because here whenever Trey plays this, whether it's an acoustic show or on that late night thing, he just goes to the C major flat 5 and then goes into the ending chords. But if you listen to the full band, he hits this and they start doing this ascending descending thing, which is super cool. And when I actually recorded this tune with my daughter, someone called me out for not doing this part. So to whoever that was, here's what happens there. So it's dun. Right, and they do these ascending, descending things. But in the acoustic version, it doesn't do that. So we'll stick with the acoustic version. So you go to that C major 5-5. Your ending jam riff thing. So I'll tell you, these are funky chords. I haven't actually thought through what they are. You're gonna start on the on your D string, now E string, on the 11th fret, 9th fret on the G string, and 10th fret on the B string. So it kind of looks like that. If this string weren't tuned differently, this would be an A major, and this would be your third. But since it's tuned up a whole step, it's a flat 5. So this is an A major flat 5 to, this looks like a C, but your 1 is tuned up a whole step. So I give up, my brain's tired at this point. So it looks like a C major shape, 1-3-5, but this isn't the 1, it's the 2, so it's 2-3-5, which probably makes it some other chord. Like I said, I give up trying to name these right now, but you'll play it like a C chord, so that's 10-9-8 to your G major flat 5, which again looks like a G major of a 3-5-1 voicing, but it's not. And then a D major. And he plays a D major like this, which is, you've got your A here. Again, it's confusing because you want it to be G, but it's not, it's A. And then you've got your 1 and your 3, which is your D and F sharp on the G and B string. Okay? So we'll just play those again. Pebbles and marbles, like things on my mind. Pebbles and marbles, like things on my mind. Pebbles and marbles, like things on my mind. Acoustic versions, Trey ends with a nice little resolve on the A major, and then as you know, in the full band version, they end on some dissonant chord nodal things. Anyways, there's the whole freaking thing. It's a tricky tune. The trickiest part is really getting all this stuff to go with the chords. So you gotta really practice that. I would recommend just sitting, take that C major, C major flat 5, really, then just try that. And when I'm not really focusing and I play it, and I'm not, you know, really giving it my all, I go to my sort of natural, which is... Yeah. Anyways, I gotta practice it too. So, hope you enjoyed it. There's a whole lot there, but it's super fun, and I think it's cool to try to figure out all those different chords and what the alternate tunings do to it. Really clever of Trey to figure out how to get the beautiful voicings by just changing one string. What a guy. All right, hope you enjoyed. Share it, subscribe, like, follow, blah, blibbity blah. Peace.